we will be learning about the Watchdog Manager today, its features, and the interaction with the other models and why we need it. Let's start. So, what is Watchdog Manager? A Watchdog Manager is a basic software module at the service layer of the Hadoop. It acts as a supervisor for the configured program execution, that is so-called supervised entity. When it detects a violation for the configured logical constraints on program execution, it takes a number of configurable action to recover from this failure. A supervised entity can be an OS application, say task, software component, or a CDD. It also handles the triggering of the hardware watchdog via watchdog interface. Let's take an example where, due to an unknown failure, execution is of supervised entity is interrupted. In the absence of watchdog manager, the watchdog driver can still receive the trigger as it is being triggered from another independent program. Such failures won't be able to capture without watchdog manager. In such scenario, the watchdog M will detect this failure and hence restrict the watchdog trigger in order to reset the microcontroller and hence to enter the fail-safe state. As we can see here, it is layered software architecture of Hadoop. The topmost layer is the application layer, followed by the RTE. Purple color represents the service layer. Then we have the ECU abstraction layer, and then this is the MQL layer. In the parallel, we also have the complex device driver layer on the right side. Watchdog M is part of the basic software service layer. Watchdog M have also the port interfaces to inform the global status of the configured supervised entity, and also the client server interfaces can be used by software component for alive indication. Watchdog M controls the watchdog drivers via watchdog interface. We can configure internal or external watchdog in watchdog interface, and then it can be referred in watchdog M configuration. Also to note, external watchdog implementation could be part of the CDD, and obviously internal watchdog comes from the MQL layer. Let's just list out the feature of the watchdog manager. The first one is a live supervision, and this will be used for the supervised entities which are periodic. Second is the deadline monitoring, which will be used for the aperiodic supervised entities. The logical monitoring could be used for the series of program which needs to be executed. Fourth one is the error handling. We will see how the watchdog manager handles the errors for the local and the global status of supervised. So the fifth one is watchdog driver handling, that also will be handled from watchdog manager. Let's go to next slide for the details. One of the supervision function of the watchdog manager is alive supervision. Alive supervision offers a mechanism to periodically check the execution reliability of one or several supervised entities. This mechanism supports a check of cyclic timing constants of independent supervised entities, which means that it will be used for the supervised entities which are periodic. So it could be a task or a software component or an API. Let's see the configuration parameters. For example, the period of supervised entity is 5 milliseconds and watchdog M main function is in the 20 millisecond task. Then expected alive indication, the first parameter will be 4. Why? Because we are expecting supervised entity to come at least 4 times within the 20 milliseconds. The next is maximum and the minimum margin. It will provide a range of indication if we keep those values to 1 and 1, which means that the expected alive indication is 4 plus 1 and 4 minus 1. So between between 3 and 5. At last we have supervision reference cycle. It can be set to 1 if we want to evaluate the result in each 20 millisecond when watchdog main function will be called. So we'll take one more example. If we have one supervised entity with 100 millisecond period, then the supervision reference cycle could be 5, which is 20 ms into 5. Let's see an example of live supervision indication. Here we can see that supervised entity can call watchdog M checkpoint reached API with a supervised entity ID and the checkpoint ID, and this call will be required only once in case of alive indication. The solve for AS, let's go to the next slide. Deadline supervision checks the timing constraint of non-cyclic supervised entities. For example, if we have two such checkpoints, one is start and one is the end, watchdog manager can supervise the timing between the start and the end checkpoint, and it will be comparing this value with the configured value. And we do have the two configured value, one is the minimum time and one more is the maximum time. Now let's see what and all possible configuration we can have. One simple configuration it will have that it will one supervised entity will have only one transition with two checkpoints, one for starting and one for the ending. Okay, and we can have also more than one transition for one supervised entity, and also the transition and the checkpoints do not have to form a closed group, since only the start and the end checkpoints are considered by the supervision function. There can be independent graph as well. Moreover, the checkpoints can be chained. Now let's see one example. In this example, we can see two instances of call to watchdog checkpoint reached API. It is required to inform watchdog manager about start and end of the execution for a particular supervised entity. The timestamps will be saved during this operation by watchdog manager, and this will be evaluated at the watchdog manager main function cycle. Okay, now we'll see the configuration parameter for the deadline supervision. Can see the first two we have is the reference to the checkpoint which we have. For first one is for start and the second one is for stop, and then also we need to provide the minimum time and the maximum time for the deadline. So that's all we have the configuration for the deadline supervision. So the logical supervision will be providing us an ability to monitor the sequence of the execution of the program between the checkpoint. So if we have four APIs which we are expecting to be executed in a sequential way, then we can put four different checkpoints on each of them, and then it will be informing the watchdog manager when they are executed, and based on this information we could deduce that it has been called sequentially or not. So this is how the logical supervision will be used. We can now see the simple example of the logical supervision, where in this program we see that it is being monitored for each step from CP00 to CP06. Let's see the same sequential diagram in a control flow diagram, and now here we see that CP00 will start and will go to CP01, then from there it could go to CP02, and from there it could go to CP03 or 4 and then 5, and also it could go from CP05 to CP01 and again from 1 to 6. So this kind of configuration is possible inside the watchdog manager. So we can have something like this with more complicated sequences also possible to configure. Let's talk about the error handling. First of all, we'll see the local status. Here, based on the configuration, these transition will be changing. So at the beginning we will have the watchdog M status as okay, and when we have some failure then it will pass either 2 or 3. And going from okay to the expire also depends on the configuration. So one of the configuration is the tolerance. If the tolerance is set to 0, then it will be following the second flow. Or if we have the failure tolerance more than 0, then it will be following 3, and then it will go to the failed state, and based on this tolerance it will again go back to the 6 to the expired. But in case of when we have a correct behavior from the supervised entity, then it could also go back using the fifth line to the okay status. Let's go to the global status. Based on the local status, we could do the end operation for the multiple supervised entities, which means that if we have 4 different supervised entity and if we got one local status failure, then how it should be evaluated, that also can be configured. So for example, we could also give, so if we end operation of the local status of multiple supervised entity will be resulting in a global status. Here also we have the status okay, and then the failed, and based on the tolerance it could go to expired or to stopped. And also it has one more possibility is there, from okay to the stopped directly. For the details of each transition you could also refer to the Watchdog M software spec from Autosa. Okay, now we'll see what and all the actions can be taken from the Watchdog manager. First is the partition shutdown. If the supervised entity is in the separate partition, the Watchdog manager could request the operating system via BSWM to restart the partition. The second option is to do hardware watchdog reset, which means that it could stop the triggering of the watchdog and then consequently will have the watchdog resetting the microcontroller. The third action Watchdog M can take is to cause an immediate reset for certain condition. We can also do the configuration for immediate MCU reset. One more important action it could take is, it could inform the software component or the CDD about the status of global error. Let's see what and all the interfaces we have for the lower layers. So the first one is for setting the modes. We have fast and the slow mode, also the off mode, which the watchdog manager can request via watchdog interface by calling this API. Second interface it will have for setting the trigger condition. So in each watchdog M main function cycle, it will be updating the trigger condition, and based on this watchdog driver will be doing the trigger. So for example, when we want to do a reset, when we have the global status as expired, at that time it will update the trigger condition as false, and hence the watchdog trigger won't take place, and hence we get the microcontroller reset. Thank you so much for listening. Please subscribe to my channel. Bye bye.